This video is intended to give an overview of the model 9-4 and 9-4 RF ion chambers. The Ludlum Model 9-4 is a 5-range ion chamber instrument designed for measuring beta gamma radiation up to 50 R per hour. The chamber wall and beta slide are 1,000 milligrams per centimeter squared thick. It has a retractable beta shield that allows for a measurement of beta particles through a 7 milligram per centimeter square window when the slide is open. The Model 9-4 RF version is designed to be resistant to radio frequency fields and meets radiation survey requirements for television receiver and cabinet X-ray systems requirements in accordance with 21 CFR 1020.10 and 21 CFR 1020.40. In addition, it is insensitive to RF fields of 10 milliwatts per square centimeter. The 9-4 RF model has a special type of gasket material for the chassis. When opening and closing the chassis, be sure the gasket remains intact. If it is damaged or broken, RF energy can penetrate inside the meter and cause interference. Functionally, the 9-4 RF is the same as a standard model 9-4, and we will only refer to the model 9-4 for the rest of this video. The 9-4 is both temperature and pressure compensated, which allows the instrument to measure within 20% of the true value even when the temperature is varied from negative 4 to plus 122 degrees Fahrenheit, and it measures within plus or minus 15% as the pressure is varied from 20.7 to 31.3 inches of mercury. The range selector switch is a 6-position rotary switch. Turning the range selector switch from off to one of the range multipliers provides the operator with an overall range of 0 to 50,000 mR per hour. In this example, the needle is pointed at approximately 4.25 and the range switch is on the times 1 range. So the instrument is reading approximately 4.25 mR per hour. The bat test button is used to check the status of the batteries. The meter should read within the bat test scale on the meter. The range switch may be in any position except off for the battery test. The light toggle switch turns the LED light on the meter off and on. The zero adjust knob is a full one-turn control that allows for compensation of electrometer drift. The reset button is used to drive the needle to zero. On the times 1 and times 10 ranges, pressing the reset button induces a voltage transient. You have to hold the reset button down for 5 seconds to allow the transient to decay. The needle will indicate a countdown during this time. Similarly, when the reset button switch is released on these ranges, another transient occurs and another 5-second recovery countdown occurs. The beta shield on the bottom of the meter can be opened to allow exposure to beta radiation through a window with a thickness of 7 milligrams per square centimeter. With the shield closed, beta radiation cannot be detected. The battery should be checked each time the instrument is turned on. Turn the rotary dial to times 10K position. The meter will do a 5-second countdown, then will go to zero. Press the bat test button. Ensure the needle goes into the black arrow portion on the meter dial. If it reads less than that, replace the batteries with fresh ones. If the meter does not respond, check to see if the batteries have been correctly installed. To install batteries, ensure the range selector switch is in the off position. Open the battery lid by pushing down and turning the quarter turn thumb screw counterclockwise a quarter of a turn. Note the plus and minus marks inside the battery holder. Match the battery polarity to these marks. Close the battery box lid. Then push down and turn the quarter turn thumb screw clockwise a quarter of a turn. Zero the meter by pressing and holding the reset button. The meter needle will display a countdown from 5 to 0 when the reset button is pressed. Adjust the zero adjust knob until a meter reading of 0 is obtained. When the needle is on the zero, release the reset button. Another 5-second countdown will occur to allow voltage transient to decay. The model 9-4 is now ready to use. Ludlum Measurements offers a 1 microcurie cesium-137 source for sale that can be used as a check source. A source this size is called an exempt quantity, and as such, it is exempt from NRC regulations to possess, use, transfer, dispose, or ship. To perform the operational test, first ensure that the meter is properly zeroed. Open the beta shield, but be careful when the beta slide is open because the Mylar window is fragile and may be damaged or punctured quite easily. Expose the check source to the center of the chamber window. The instrument should read plus or minus 20% of the recorded reference reading. If the instrument fails to read within 20% of the reference reading, you should check the condition of the desiccant. How to check the desiccant is explained in the next section. If the desiccant is okay, then the meter should be taken out of service and/or sent to a calibration facility for recalibration. Disassemble the chassis by unlocking the latches and pulling it apart. If the desiccant inside the plastic box is blue, it is still good and you can use the instrument. If the desiccant is pink, it needs to be refreshed or replaced with a fresh box. The restraining strap may be released by pressing the center tab toward the strap, thus releasing the desiccant box. A desiccant that has turned pink may be recycled by placing it in an oven at around 130 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours or in a microwave on the high setting for 10 seconds. If condensed water is apparent, wipe off the water and heat for another 10 seconds. Repeat until the box and desiccant appear dry and the desiccant is blue. We recommend using our small carrying case, part number 2311062, which is sold separately, to store, transport, or ship the meter. The case is waterproof and airtight. It also makes for a convenient place to store your check source. If a cesium check source of less than 10 microcuries is being included in the shipment, then the outside of the box or carrying case, if it is not inside a box, must be marked with UN2910. That concludes our video on the basic use of a Model 9-4 ion chamber.